Hey YouTube, what's going on? I hope you can hear me okay. I thought I'd make an update about what's going on with my laptop computer since I accidentally spilt some diet drink in it yesterday. I took it to my computer guy, my friend who fixes my computers and stuff, and he looked at it and he's pretty fast with computers anyway, but he looked at it and told me today that bad news was that, well, actually it was bad news and good news. Good news is the computer wasn't busted, so I didn't fry any of the components, didn't fry any of the motherboard, didn't fry the motherboard or the RAM or anything like that. So I was pretty relieved about that. Also didn't fry the hard drives or anything, so I was pretty happy about that. But he said, "Well, the bad news is you screwed up your trackpad and you have lost your keyboard." And he suggested that I would either get an external keyboard and an external mouse, and it would kind of make it like a laptop that's a desktop. So I was like, "Well, what other options do I got? Sorry, I can't stand this little camera here on this desk sometimes." But anyway, I asked him what the other thing he would got, what the other options was. He said, "Well, you can find a keyboard for it, an internal keyboard for it, and it might cost about $125 to get a new keyboard, and I would have to it would probably take about 2 weeks to get the keyboard, and I would once I got it, I would have to pretty much gut your machine and put in another keyboard and then rebuild your computer back to the settings that you have. You still wouldn't have a mouse. Your mouse pad's pretty much shot. The trackpad on it's pretty shot, so you're gonna have to get a external mouse, whatever you do." So he looked around and come to find out, he found a keyboard for my computer for $20. And so he said it's gonna take about 2 weeks to get it here. And I said, "Yeah, go ahead and do that. I need to have a key, need to have a laptop and computer. It's still what I do most of my video editing on, and it's still what I do most of my internet stuff on. And right now, I can't afford a brand new computer or an upgraded computer. I can't even afford to get right now. I couldn't even afford to get the RAM that I need to upgrade to what I was wanting to, which would only been up to from 6 to 8 gigs of RAM. Now that I'm gonna have to shell out $20 for a new keyboard and $15 for an external mouse, and I've already paid him $10 for me have for my stupidity, and I'm taking up a lot of his time and a lot of his energy. He's got three other computers he's working on, so he's having to really take out a lot of time and effort for this computer, this laptop that I've stupidly spilt diet drink in." But luckily I was pretty happy when he said that I found the keyboard you need for $20. It'd be up to 2 weeks, and then once I get it and I'll start on it. As soon as I get the keyboard, I'll start on it, and it will take anywhere from 3 or 4 to 6 hours to put a new keyboard in the computer itself." So yeah, I hit a little snag there. Not gonna be put up any videos for this week because of the jam of this stupidity on my part. But I should be able to next week. I'm going to have to use my slower, much slower computer than what this laptop is that I have been using. But it's going to take some time to make them with a single core processor. And, you know, that's pretty much all I'm going to be able to do on that computer. I'm not going to be able to do anything else. You know, like surfing the net and all that. I'm just going to have to devote all the time and energy for that one little motherboard there and that 2 little gigs of RAM to plug away at rendering whatever I happen to get next week. You know, I would go ahead and start doing this week's, but it's on my hard drive of the computer that I've pretty much screwed the keyboard up on. So until I can get it back, I'm having to use the family computer here, which is, it's decent. I mean, it's a single core processor too. It's got slightly bit more RAM, and I can do all the little minor things I need to do, like Skype with my friends and do the Google Hangouts and get on here and make a YouTube video every now and then and you know, do some minor surfing on the web and check things on Facebook, and you know, I can do the minor stuff I usually do anyway. You know, listen to that's pretty much all I do anyway. But I cannot do video editing on this desktop. One, because it's way too slow, and then two, I don't have the software on it to do it. And three, it's the family's computer, so you know, I can't hog up this thing. So other than that, I'm pretty glad that I looked out the way I did with getting a keyboard for $20, not having to have a laptop for 2 weeks. A major laptop is a little bit of a bummer, but I can deal with it. You know, it might give me a chance to actually do something around the house, like clean up my room and clean up around the house and actually get some caught up on some reading I need to do, or I've been wanting to do. So anyway, just thought people would like to know what's going on. Oh, by the way, Z, thank you so much, King Z, for making that video that I made, that you made in response to my YouTubing in the dining room area yesterday. It really meant a lot to me that you made a response video like that, plugging my coffee shop. And, oh, by the way, the name of our town is, you about got it right. It's not Galaxton, it's called Galax, which, if you really want to look it up, Galax is a leaf that is in this area of the mountains of Virginia and North Carolina, and it's only grown in like a 50 mile radius. So, you know, that's a little fascinating fact for you right there. If you want to know what Galax is, it's a Galax leaf, is what it is. And it's the shape of a heart. Matter of fact, if you go on my coffee shop channel on YouTube and you see the little logo that we have of the coffee cup and the fiddle and the bow on it, and then we got the shamrock on one side, representing our tea room that we have, and then we have the other side, which is the Galax leaf. That's what it is. And you know, it's fascinating that only one specific kind of leaf can grow in a one little region of Virginia and North Carolina border little mountain area here. And it's only growing in a 50-mile radius. So, yeah, that's a little fascinating fact for you there. So, hope you enjoyed this video. Keep watching me. And encourage me during these 2 weeks not having a pretty fast computer. I appreciate it, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.